So this is also about finance. It's also about distribution of information, transparency, and so on. In this case, I wanted to provide a service to democratize offshore business for people who don't want to pay for the earning. It empowers everyone to evade taxes, hide money and debts, and get away with anything by stealing identity of real offshore companies. So in this case also took me quite a bit of research and investigation, and so I interviewed the expert about offshore finance out there already a few years ago to understand what was first of all about. And then I decided to focus on Cayman Island, although there are like plenty of offshore countries, including Switzerland, of course. Somehow the data of companies incorporated the Cayman Island wasn't public. So I went to the website of the Cayman Island Registry, where you can find also the register of people that get married. And among those, there are also companies that are incorporated on the Cayman Island. And so through a script, I managed to extract to get all the list of the companies that ended up to be more than 200,000 companies incorporated there. Among them, multinationals, banks, and a weird name that no one knows what they're about. So what to do with those names? Well, I found then a certificate of incorporation that is a document that basically is the ID of this company. And so I just decided to counterfeit it with my own certificate of incorporation, with my name, my real name, my real signature, but keeping the name of the companies and the real tax number of the company. And so then I just start to sell these identities, these documents on Loophole for All. So on this website, you can search for any name of company that you like, and then you can buy this certificate. You could buy this certificate, and you could also buy a mailbox that came in Ireland, so properly pretending to be those company. The reason why it could work is because at the Cayman Island, there is a secrecy regarding the real owner of this company, right? They sell anonymity. So because of that, everyone can pretend to be that company, that owner of that company. And so this is really about corporate identity theft. That is actually a real thing happening. So in this project also happened that it generated media reaction, personal reaction, and legal reaction. So the media reaction was first on the Cayman Island. That was funny enough for me. So this is like a video that you can see online, don't screen it, from the national TV, the Cayman Island, where they say this hacker is just doing copy and paste, don't worry, it's not gonna change everything. Here, and so that generated though some debate inside the Cayman Island. It was really interesting because usually the critiques always come from outside, right? So this is like someone saying why the government doesn't sue these artists, and someone say, oh, this is just like, a comedian might say that the real ones are also fake, which is true. And another interesting press reaction is from Bermuda. So it happened that Bermuda, this is the newspaper from Bermuda, and they were worried that these artists could go there and target through the same system by counterfeiting the certificate of incorporation. So somehow it was working as a threat. And then I start to get kind of a personal reaction somehow. So again, people writing me and say, oh, I have a store, a fruit store here in Spain. Could I use your offshore system to not pay taxes for, selling banana, basically? And yes, and usually I reply them, I explain what is the idea behind and so on. So, but after a while, that actually after a couple of weeks that I was selling these companies for real and I was making money, PayPal, that was basically the platform that I used to sell this service, basically froze all the money that they made and banned the account on PayPal, basically saying that I was I was engaging people in illegal activity. But the interesting thing is that this letter is from Luxembourg. That's another offshore center, so it's only questionable here who is actually breaking the law and which law. And so, in fact, this project really regards what is law today in a globalized world and you know, interconnected world that's online, where is the jurisdiction that hold on financial transaction or any type of crime, right, at this point. So to publish this project, I set up the same structure that multinationals use to avoid legal liability and also avoiding taxes. So I am based in New York, so that is my headquarter and is in the center. And I incorporated myself in the city of London, that is another offshore center. And the financial transactions were happening in Luxembourg, so I was supposing to pay or not to pay taxes in London and transferring the cash in New York. But and while the incorporation also like all to shield my legal responsibility for what I was doing at the Cayman Island, while my citizenship is Italian, so it was really hard to look after me from the Cayman Island and also from the US. And the data is instead stored in a server in California that facilitates the publishing of this kind of data. So this was my structure, pretty much a basic thing that every company would do today. So another kind of personal reaction was from this real, honest, legit company at the Cayman Islands that say, you know, we are concerned about the identity theft, this seems to promote that, what's going on here, and they say, okay, sorry, you weren't like on my list as a target, so I will just remove you. But there are also people that instead got really upset. So in this case, for example, it's a small company, and it's like really saying, you know, insulting me, and saying, you know, Cayman Islands is actually part of the UK territory, so I am going to call the local police here, and I will put you in jail. And they reply, no, please don't do that, and so on, and I try to engage them in a conversation. So after a while, there are the big fish coming up. So this, for example, the this is a huge hedge fund company based in Hong Kong and Beijing. And so they asked to remove four company, this Snowflake, Lake China. And so the interesting thing that they always send the letter to this London address, city of London address. And also in this case, it's really interesting for me because this is also a major bank and is sent from one Wall Street. And I live in Chinatown, I live down the street. So it's interesting that the neighbor is like trying to send me a legal threat through London while it's actually next door to me. It's a personal thing. Instead, this is also a really recent one. So this is like the major energy company in South Korea. So it's like the BP of Korea, basically, writing me and say, you know, you have to remove absolutely this subsidiary from your website. I am a New York lawyer, blah, blah, blah. So such of like aggressive letter. And then I look it up and I find that there are actually, I also try to negotiate with these people. It's really risky, but I try. So in this case, I found there are five companies with this name. So I ask them, can you really claim the ownership of all these five companies? So trying to challenge them on the truth, and they say, well, I claim the ownership of only two companies that have basically the same name. As you can see, it's like Milmeran Holding 5 and 6, but I don't know who owned the 1 and 2, right? Okay, who knows? And this is also like an interesting one. So in this case, they were really more aggressive. And this is like basically a law firm based on the Isle of Man, that I guess you guys know where it is. And these guys are basically lawyers that set up offshore business for rich people, right? So in this case, they asked me to remove every single company that contained the name Sovereign. That unfortunately was really common, and so I couldn't really negotiate with them, and they asked, yes, but you have to prove ownership of these companies, otherwise I'm not going to remove them. Unfortunately, they were 90 companies, and with that keyword, so I had to remove everything because they didn't want to negotiate everything, and they didn't want to get in trouble with a really powerful law firm. But the interesting thing that then I look it up, investigate on the name of the founder of this law firm, accounting firm, that is this guy, Hodgson Bilton, that's like a British billionaire, of course, but the interesting thing is also like art collectors, and he ran two art awards in China and in Africa. And so it was really nice to get in touch with a powerful collectors, after all. That is all.